Strangely, the MFRS data suggests the average response time in personal capacity location is exactly the same as is currently achieved on the combined Upton West Gateway station in Upton. This means there's no collective gain in average response time. Moving to Saughall Massie, and the actual areas of most frequent emergencies up to lunches will certainly experience increased response times. And I believe it's worth repeating, the proposal would increase by, I believe, 2 minutes response times to Harrow Park Hospital, which has 900 beds, and the 14-storey Brighton Rail Tower. I find that incredible. And while we're talking about the Harrow Park Hospital, there's a letter here that I got a copy of from a lady who I'm not going to mention. She might be the audience, and she'll know who is stronger for this. She points to an article she printed a little bit and asked members to do the honour of reading it. I'll then put through what she says. What Chief Fire Officer Dan Stevens does not appear to have taken on board at a park hospital is that every ward, every clinic, the access emergency department, special care lady units, maternity units, operating theatre in the hospital have piped oxygen in situ. That, in the event of fire, is very, very dangerous. There are also other chemicals on site, clearly, for a hospital needs. In the event of emergency, we need, this lady worked at our hospital, we need immediate access to a fire service, and not the one on the side of a hill, with all the potential obstacles mitigating the arrival scene of the emergency. Further, the fire station Upton has easy access to those built-up urban areas in Wirral, including the one church, over church, and the M53. She then goes on to talk about Mr. Jeffrey Scott, HGV driver, with 25 years' experience. And he pointed out in the letter to Glow that fire crew drivers may be very capable professionals, and I agree with that entirely. But, he says, it's foolhardy to expect all of the users of those narrow lanes to cope with a sudden, unexpected, blue light driver situation. Says this would be a recipe for disaster. The lanes are impassable in extreme weather conditions. Farmers use the lanes to transport cattle. Whilst cattle are lovely bovine creatures, they are unpredictable. And I found this out last time when I spoke to the Lavelles of farmers at Three Lanes End. I didn't realise that most cows give milk for pregnancy. Well, it's a lesson. And what they say is, pregnant cows in a herd are very easily spooked and they'll go in any direction they choose if a blue light comes up there. This letter says, finally, I feel it is truly reprehensible to think of building a fire station next to a complex of social housing built for the threatened elderly, I agree entirely, whilst there are potential building sites of equal distance up to Muskegon and beyond, if the Chief Fire Officer, Dan Stevens, cared to seek and find. It's clear from the, it's clear from the stations that they discounted, or the areas they discounted, that they didn't really look at them in great depth. They tried to make contact with some landowners, didn't get a response, so discounted it. That's not really trying very hard, is it, Chair? You know? If you want to find out something, you've got to knock on the door. You know, they have got transports, haven't they? You know? Moving on anyway. The officer's report states that West Gairby has a proportionally high number of residents over 65. And we know that people over 65 are more at risk. But the data supplied by the fire service says, and I state, should be noted, the data shows that Upton has more properties that cater for elderly than Hoylake and Mells. So, you know, the officer's report clearly believes what the fire authority have said to it, never challenged it. It's quite clear to find that there's more elderly people living in Upton than West Gairby and Thurcester. I'll also touch briefly, because this wasn't in the last report, but we had a lady who had been working away or been living away, came back, who was interested in architecture. Her name is Jenny Wally. And she talked about ancient artifacts that were found by the anthropology spirit up from this site. And while the report states they don't believe there are any ancient artifacts in the area, you know, we put a condition in to make sure a survey is carried out. You know, that says to me the planning officer is not quite sure what he's saying, so he's trying to cover his back by saying, I don't think they're there, but let's play safe because I don't want to get myself into trouble. Chair members, this is our history, our heritage, and we must not allow it to be simply bulldozed over and lost forever. We should be protecting it for future generations. I believe in this situation I spelled out clearly and precisely why this application should not be approved. And I believe it provided a committee with sustainable reasons to justify the refusal of this application, not only on the grounds that it refused the application in December last year, but also on the grounds that it is simply not proven very special circumstances exist to develop on green belts. So in summary, Chair and members, Merseyside Fire and Rescue own data shows 77% of the call-outs are to Ultimate Church, including the 900 bed out of hospital, and yet they want to move them in 2 minutes further away, their highest instances of response, and 2 minutes further away from the sheltered 14-storey tower that is cracking up. MFRS data shows that Ultimate Church station area has more properties at Catesford Avenue than Hoylake Mills and West Gaming Thurston, if they want to move a minimum of 2 minutes further away from those very people. And perhaps more importantly, by the applicant's own admission of pre-planning, supported by Chief Fire Officer, there is an alternative to Upton Station, which has been providing cover for the last 2 years, and continue to do so within response times. And not forgetting, there's still a further non-greenbelt site, the fire service's second choice, 700 metres from its application site, but for reasons best known to them, they chose none of these alternative options and therefore failed to meet the guidelines within Wirral GDP. Planning policy GB2, in that there is a viable alternative site at Upton in the urban area that is not in the green belt, and therefore they have failed to demonstrate the very special circumstances to justify development on green belt. I can repeat again the 6 reasons wrapped up in that 1 reason for refusal last time. I won't bother because I know everyone's getting a bit edgy. But you know, I'll say this finally. We do have, all of us as elected members, we all have a responsibility to protect the immunity of local residents, particularly those who are living there. Those are the very residents who live in Woodpecker and close to Southern Massachusetts, and we must ensure they are protected at all costs. If tonight you as a committee approve this application, not only will you be damaging the immunity of those residents we should be protecting, you'll also be setting a precedent that could be damaging to Wirral's greenbelt policies. So, Chair members, on behalf of all the residents I represent, I respectfully ask that you refuse this application. Thank you, Chair.
Idling engines as pretending calls or can go applicant has submitted an acoustic report which demonstrates that the most important sources with regards to the sensitive premises nearby are the idling engines and the walls. There is a proposal, if committee are minded to accept the application, to apply a condition requiring that all fixed plant machinery must meet certain standards so that it will not make a significant impact on the residential properties. The fire authority have submitted figures for call outs for nighttime call outs, which indicate on average in a week there will be 3 nighttime call outs between 11 p.m. and 7 a.m. which would cause some impact. The standards that the acoustic experts have applied on looked at say that this is within acceptable levels from environmental health point of view. With regards to burning and smoke, there currently aren't any conditions that restrict this proposed. The existing law of statutory nuisance would apply in the event of this causing a nuisance to residents. The fire authority would have if there was a nuisance, what's called best practical means, they would have to demonstrate that they're doing everything reasonably can do. If members are minded, they could apply another condition to try and control this. Otherwise, the existing legislation would impose controls on that activity.
Thank you. Bear with me. Just a couple of things, really. Kevin Key was made reference to the fact that he was denied to show a short film. Could I ask for comment on that, please?
Yeah, the right of the petitioner to speak is that they may address the committee for up to 5 minutes, and it is considered that a